Okay, as I was saying, all right, all of you already learned how to differentiate a composite function. But when there are two composite functions, okay, side by side to each other, the two composite functions multiply to each other, all right, you cannot just do the normal way. This is why we need to learn the product rule. Okay, so this product rule, okay, it's the first time you are seeing it, but don't worry, all right, we'll keep in mind first. Okay, I'm going to make use of a question over here. Okay, can you see in question 1A, there are two composite functions. Okay, if you don't like to see as a composite function, I keep using the word composite function, see as there are two bracket terms. Can you all see there are two bracket terms? Jinhao, can you tell me in the first bracket, what's the power? In the first bracket, the first composite function, what's the power? 1. In the second composite function, what's the power? 6. Okay? So for the convenience, I'm just going to write out the question first. 4x minus 3, 2x plus 7 to the power of 6. Okay, see what I'm going to do first. Alright, don't copy, just see first. I'm going to apply the two step if I want to do my differentiation. Okay, Deepak, what is the first composite function that you will see? What is the first composite function that you see on the screen which I just wrote? First bracket term. First bracket term. Okay. So Deepak finally told us the first composite function is 4x minus 3. What is step number one? Differentiate the first. Meaning differentiate the first bracket term. Deepak, how to differentiate 4x minus 3? Okay, take note. Because it's power 1, so long it's power 1, don't worry about the power. Why? Because after you bring out the power, 1 minus 1 will give you what? 0 to anything to the power of 0 will be 1. 1, right? Okay. So, if you don't believe, I'm going to show a long method first. Okay, I do what Deepak is going to tell us first. Bring down the power. Reduce the power by 1, you will get. After that, differentiate the term inside the bracket. What do you get? 4. Okay, what do you realize? The one that I read are written in red. The only answer left, if I simplify, is the number 4. Okay, so as such, I want to let you know, whenever the composite function is power 1, right? Don't worry about bringing down the power. It's as good as telling me, just differentiate the terms in the bracket. This is unique. Can? Okay, so I erase. Too long. Because power 1 is unique. So it's as good as telling me, I just need to differentiate the term inside the bracket. But I differentiate the first already. Keep the second. So I continue writing the second. So, add to the second step. What's the second step? Differentiate the second. Okay, this one I need to be careful because it's power 6. Grace, how do I differentiate the second? Okay, which is? Okay, bring down the 6. Okay, wait, too fast. Okay, then 6 minus 1 give us 5. Are we done? Differentiate the term inside, right? What do you get? 2. After that, are we done? We are done with differentiating the second. We must keep the first. So let me write the first. Okay, so after we have performed the two step for product rule, take note, check for common terms. All right, you can clearly see 2x plus 7 is the common term. So we need to F it, factorize it. Take out the one with the smaller power, like what you all have just told me. So I'm going to do that. All right, the smaller power is power 5. So I'm going to take out the one with the smaller power. And then the rest of the terms which I did not take out, I'll put it inside the square bracket. Okay, there must be a power 1 here. Because power 5 plus power 1 multiplication of same base, I'll still sum up to power 6. Alright? Then plus 6. Okay, at this moment, do you think my factorization is good? So if you are able to simplify the square bracket, after that you realize inside the square bracket there is a common number 8. So I factorize some more. Okay, the usual question where some student will ask me, yes, this answer is very good, but teacher, what if I leave the answer here? Is this acceptable? We will still accept, even if you never factorize the 8. So this is also okay. But if you ask me, this is a better answer. All right?